little children always bossy? Is the baby always babied? The answer is yes, if you believe in the science of birth order. Michael Grose has written several books on the subject and he joins us now. Michael! Hello. This, I think, is such a fascinating topic. I'm a firstborn.
We all
married
like to talk
to,
about it ourselves.
Of
yeah.
course we do. And married to a firstborn.
Okay.
Yeah.
So life's tense. Yeah, life's tense. I always think when I look at people who are two firstborns who are married to each other, I think they've sort of got worked out in the womb which school they're going to go to. And the two youngest are married. I don't know how the garbage is put out, but it's a pretty happy family.
So what's the perfect situation for a firstborn? What's the best character type?
I think the youngest one.
Really?
Yeah, well, often works out. Often what the research shows that two middles work out quite well. It's very about flexibility. But I'm the youngest one in the family, and I've sort of worked out that my wife is the second born, but she functions like firstborn. She was the
That's
eldest
me.
Girl, so
right.
to speak. So life's beautiful. It's just so lovely because so I'm looking for some. She's looking for someone to look out for, and I'm sort of looking for someone who can sort of
look after, you.
Look after me.
So, what are the sweeping generalisations then? That the okay. firstborn is the responsible one, the bossy one, the one who takes control.
Yeah, I'm glad you said generalisations because they are, but. Generally, you hit the mark with all those, and also they're the family, what we call the family standard bearer. So if you're an academic family, there's a reasonable chance your firstborn will be an academic one.
Right.
Very much, yeah.
Does it differ from gender, or is it the same?
Yeah, gender makes a difference.
Yep.
Doesn't make as much difference as we perhaps think. Where I think it really does make a difference, it'll be interesting with the birth of the new royal birth, because we've got a boy who's firstborn, we've got a girl who's coming in 2 years younger. Because of the maturity gap, the one thing you want to be if you're a firstborn is have a sort of competency gap between you and the ones that follow. So often girls who are born first, second, with an elder brother, those girls can sometimes overtake them. And suddenly they're the readers, they're the verbal ones, and sometimes firstborn boys can sort of step back. They'll either withdraw, they'll sometimes be quite sort of antagonistic.
And what about the youngest ones? Are they typically, I guess, what, spoiled? Modicod, sense of entitlement? I'm just guessing here.
Well, they have two advantages. They have advantage. The advantage simply is that they've got parents who are... Someone else has broken in their parents for them.
Mm-hmm.
So they experience more relaxed parenting. And the second thing is they're born into a situation where you can't out... sort of smart your elder sibling, but you can certainly outlast them.
Mm.
So they're very good at putting other people in their service.
And outcharm them as well.
And charm them. And they like attention. Yeah.
Is there a likely placehood in the order of things that you're going to be a comedian? Because
I think middle child.
From my experience, there is, actually.
And where do you think that would be?
It'd be the second or youngest.
I'm the youngest.
Yeah. Right.
But what if this middle child syndrome, are they attention seekers?
They tend to be more flexible. They are, and one of the simple reasons is they have to fit in with the life of the firstborn.
Because they're never special.
Yeah, well, every child's special.
Indeed, we are all special.
Jan
Michael
Brady.
Grose, thank you so much for coming in.
It's a pleasure.
We could keep talking, but we've run out of time. Thank you so much. And if you'd like any details on any of Michael's terrific books, we have all of that on our website. Okay.